This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. PowerPC, a backronym for performance optimization with enhanced RISC, performance computing, sometimes abbreviated as PPC, is a RISC instruction set architecture created by the 1991 Apple-IBM Motorola Alliance, known as AIM PowerPC, as an evolving instruction set, has since 2006 been named PowerPC, while the old name naturally lives on, as a legacy trademark for some implementations of Power architecture-based processors, and in software package identifiers. PowerPC was the cornerstone of AIM's PrEP and Common Hardware Reference Platform initiatives in the 1990s, originally intended for personal computers. The architecture is well known for being used by Apple's Power Macintosh, PowerBook, iMac, iBook, and Xserve lines from 1994 until 2006, when Apple migrated to Intel's x86. It has since become niche in personal computers, but remained popular as embedded and high-performance processors. Its use in video game consoles and embedded applications provided an array of uses. In addition, PowerPC CPUs are still used in AmigaOne and third-party AmigaOS for personal computers. PowerPC is largely based on IBM's earlier Power instruction set architecture, and retains a high level of compatibility with it. The architectures have remained close enough that the same programs and operating systems will run on both if some care is taken in preparation. Newer chips in the Power series use the PowerPC contents. 1. History. 11. Apple and Motorola involvement. 12. Operating systems. 13. Breakup of AIM. 14. Generations. 2. Design features. 21. Endian modes. 3. Implementations. 4. Operating systems. 41. Operating systems with native support. 42. Embedded. 5. Licensees. 51. 32-bit PowerPC. 52. 64-bit PowerPC. 53. Game consoles. 54. Desktop computers. 55. Embedded applications. 6. See also. 7. References. 8. Notes. 9. External links. History. The history of RISC began with IBM's 801 research project, on which John Koch was the lead developer, where he developed the concepts of RISC in 1975 to 78,801 based microprocessors were used in a number of IBM embedded products, eventually becoming the 16-register ROMP processor used in the IBM RT. The RT was a rapid design implementing the RISC architecture between the years of 1982 to 1984. IBM started a project to build the fastest microprocessor on the market. This new 64-bit architecture became referred to as the America Project throughout its development cycle, which lasted for approximately 5 to 6 years. The result was the Power instruction set architecture, introduced with the RISC System 6000 in early 1990. The original Power microprocessor, one of the first superscalar RISC implementations, was a high-performance, multi-chip design. IBM soon realized that a single-chip microprocessor was needed in order to scale its RS-6000 line from lower-end to high-end machines. Work on a one-chip Power microprocessor, designated the RSC RISC single-chip, began in early 1991. IBM realized its design could potentially become a high-volume microprocessor used across the industry. Apple and Motorola involvement. IBM approached Apple with the goal of collaborating on the development of a family of single-chip microprocessors based on the Power architecture soon after. Apple, being one of Motorola's largest customers of desktop-class microprocessors, asked Motorola to join the discussions due to their long relationship, its more extensive experience with manufacturing high-volume microprocessors than IBM, and to form a second source for the microprocessors. This three-way collaboration became known as AIM Alliance. For Apple, IBM, Motorola. In 1991, the PowerPC was just one facet of a larger alliance among these three companies. At the time, most of the personal computer industry was shipping systems based on the Intel 80386 and 80486 chips, which had a CISC architecture, and development of the Pentium processor was well underway. The PowerPC chip was one of several joint ventures involving the three, in their efforts to counter the growing Microsoft Intel dominance of personal computing. For Motorola, Power looked like an unbelievable deal. It allowed them to sell a widely tested and powerful RISC CPU for little design cash on their own part. It also maintained ties with an important customer, Apple, and seemed to offer the possibility of adding IBM too, who might buy smaller versions from Motorola instead of making its own. At this point, Motorola already had its own RISC design in the form of the 88000, which was Doing poorly in the market, Motorola was doing well with their 68,000 family, and the majority of the funding was focused on this. The 88,000 effort was somewhat starved for resources, however, the 88,000 was already in production, Data General was shipping 88,000 machines, and Apple already had 88,000 prototype machines running. The 88,000 had also achieved a number of embedded design wins in telecom applications if the new Power One chip version could be made bus compatible at a hardware level with the 88,000, that would allow both Apple and Motorola to bring machines to market far faster, since they would not have to redesign their board architecture. The result of these various requirements was the PowerPC performance computing specification. The differences between the earlier power instruction set and PowerPC is outlined in Appendix E of the manual for PowerPC ESA V202 operating systems. When the first PowerPC products reached the market, they were met with enthusiasm. In addition to Apple, both IBM and the Motorola Computer Group offered systems built around the processors. Microsoft released Windows NT 351 for the architecture, which was used in Motorola's PowerPC servers, and Sun Microsystems offered a version of its Solaris OS. IBM ported its X-Unix and planned a release of OS 2 throughout the mid-1990s. PowerPC processors achieved benchmark test scores that matched or exceeded those of the fastest x86 CPUs. Ultimately, demand for the new architecture on the desktop never truly materialized. Windows, OS 2 and Sun customers, faced with the lack of application software for the PowerPC, almost universally ignored the chip. The PowerPC versions of Solaris, OS 2, and Windows were discontinued after only a brief period on the market, only on the Macintosh. Due to Apple's persistence, did the PowerPC gain traction to Apple? The performance of the PowerPC was a bright spot in the face of increased competition from Windows 95 and Windows NT-based PCs. In parallel with the alliance between IBM and Motorola, both companies had development efforts underway internally. The PowerQuick line was the result of this work inside Motorola. The 4XX series of embedded processors was underway inside IBM. The IBM embedded processor business grew to nearly $100 million in revenue and attracted hundreds of customers. Breakup of AIM. However, toward the close of the decade, manufacturing issues began plaguing the AIM alliance in much the same way they did Motorola, which consistently pushed back deployments of new processors for Apple and other vendors, first from Motorola in the 1990s with the PowerPC 7XX and 74XX processors, and IBM with the 64-bit PowerPC 970 processor in 2003. In 2004, Motorola exited the chip manufacturing business by spinning off its semiconductor business as an independent company called Freescale Semiconductor. Around the same time, IBM exited the 32-bit embedded processor market by selling its line of PowerPC products to Applied Micro Circuits Corporation AMCC and focusing on 64-bit chip designs, while maintaining its commitment of PowerPC CPUs toward game machine makers such as Nintendo's GameCube and Wii, Sony's PlayStation 3 and Microsoft's Xbox 360, of which the latter two both use 64-bit processors. In 2005, Apple announced they would no longer use PowerPC processors in their Apple Macintosh computers, favoring Intel-produced processors instead, citing the performance limitations of the chip for future personal computer hardware, specifically related to heat generation and energy usage, as well as the inability of IBM to move the 970 processor to the 3. As of 2015, IBM's Power microprocessors, which implement the Power ESA, are used by IBM in their IBM Power systems, running IBM iX and Linux generations. Many PowerPC designs are named and labeled by their apparent technology generation that began with the G3, which was an internal project name inside AIM for the development of what would become the PowerPC 750 family. Apple popularized the term G3 when they introduced PowerMac G3 and PowerBook G3 at an event at the 10th of November 1997. Motorola and Apple liked the moniker and used the term G4 for the 7400 family introduced in 1998 and the Power Mac G4 in 1999. At the time of the G4 was launched, Motorola categorized all their PowerPC models, former, current and future, according to what generation they adhered to, even renaming the older 603E core G2. Motorola had a G5 project that never came to fruition, version, but the name stuck and Apple reused it when the 970 family launched in 2003, even if those were designed and built by IBM PowerPC generations according to Motorola. CA 2000G1 the 601, 500 and 800 family processors G2 the 602, 603, 604, 620, 8200 and 5000 families G3 the 750 and 8300 families G4 the 7400 and 8400 families. G5 the 7500 and 8500 families. Motorola didn't use the G5 moniker after Apple usurped the name G6 the 7600. These designs didn't become real products. Design features power architecture made by Freescale PowerPC E-Series 2006 E200 E300 E500 E600 E5500 E6500 QOR Series 2008 Core Coriva made by IBM Power ESA 1990. Power Series 1990 POWER1 POWER2 POWER3 POWER4 POWER5 POWER6 POWER7 POWER8 POWER9 PowerPC Series 1992 6XX 4XX 7XX 74XX 970 A2RS 64 1996. RAD Series 1997 RAD 6000 RAD 750 RAD 5500 IBM Nintendo Collaboration Gecko Broadway Espresso Other Titan PWR Fission Cell Xenon Related Links OpenPower Foundation AIM Alliance RISC Blue Gene PowerOrg PAPR Prep CHRP Altivic More Cancelled in Gray, Historic and Italic VE The PowerPC is designed along RISC principles, and allows for a superscalar implementation. Versions of the design exist in both 32-bit and 64-bit implementations starting with the basic power specification. The PowerPC added support for operation in both Big Endian and Little Endian modes. The PowerPC can switch from one mode to the other at runtime. See below. This feature is not supported in the PowerPC 970 single precision forms of some floating point instructions, in addition to double precision forms additional floating point instructions at the behest of Apple. A complete 64-bit specification that is backward compatible with the 32-bit mode of fused multiply add a paged memory management architecture which is used extensively in server and PC systems addition of a new memory management architecture called Book E, replacing the conventional paged memory management architecture for embedded applications. Book E is application software compatible with existing PowerPC implementations, but needs minor changes to the operating system. Some instructions present in the power instruction set were deemed too complex and were removed in the PowerPC architecture. Some removed instructions could be emulated by the operating system if necessary. The removed instructions are conditional moves, load and store instructions for the quad precision floating point data type, string instructions, Endian modes. Most PowerPC chips switch Endianness via a bit in the MSR machine state register, with a second bit provided to allow the OS to run with a different Endianness. Accesses to the inverted page table, a hash table that functions as a TLB with off-chip storage, are always done in Big Endian mode. The processor starts in Big Endian mode in Little Endian mode. The three lowest order bits of the effective address are exclusive ORed with a 3-bit value selected by the length of the operand. This is enough to appear fully Little Endian to normal software. An operating system will see a warped view of the world when it accesses external chips such as video and network hardware. Fixing this warped view requires that the motherboard perform an unconditional 64-bit byte swap on all data entering or leaving the processor. Endianness thus becomes a property of the motherboard. An OS that operates in Little Endian mode on a Big Endian motherboard must both swap bytes and undo the exclusive OR when accessing Little Endian chips. Altivic operations, despite being 128-bit, are treated as if they were 64-bit. This allows for compatibility with Little Endian motherboards that were designed prior to Altivic. An interesting side effect of this implementation is that a program can store a 64-bit value, the longest operand format, to memory while in one endian mode, switch modes, and read back the same 64-bit value without seeing a change of byte order. This will not be the case if the motherboard is switched at the same time Mercury Computer Systems and Matrox ran the PowerPC in little endian mode. This was done so that PowerPC devices serving as co-processors on PCI boards could share data structures with host computers based on x86. Both PCI and x86 are little endian OS 2 and Windows NT for PowerPC. Ran the processor in little endian mode while Solaris, X and Linux ran in big endian. Some of IBM's embedded PowerPC chips use a per-page endianness bit. None of the previous applies to them implementations. IBM PowerPC 604E 200 MHz custom PowerPC CPU from the Nintendo Wii video game console. The Freescale XPC855T service processor of a Sunfire V20Z. The first implementation of the architecture was the PowerPC 601, released in 1992, based on the RISC, implementing a hybrid of the POWER1 and PowerPC instructions. This allowed the chip to be used by IBM in their existing POWER1-based platforms, although it also meant some slight pain when switching to the second generation pure PowerPC designs. Apple continued work on a new line of Macintosh computers based on the chip, and eventually released them as the 601-based Power Macintosh on March 14, 1994. IBM also had a full line of PowerPC-based desktops built and ready to ship. Unfortunately, the operating system which IBM had intended to run on these desktops, Microsoft Windows NT, was not complete by early 1993, when the machines were ready for marketing accordingly, and further because IBM had developed animosity toward Microsoft, IBM decided to rewrite OS 2 for the PowerPC. It took IBM 2 years to rewrite OS 2 for PowerPC, and by the time the operating system was ready, the market for OS 2 on PowerPC had evaporated. For this reason, the IBM PowerPC desktops did not ship, although the reference design codenamed Sandalbow based on the PowerPC 601 CPU was released as an RS 6000 model. Byte's April 1994 issue included an extensive article about the Apple and IBM PowerPC desktops. Apple, which also lacked a PowerPC-based OS, took a different route. They rewrote the essential pieces of their Mac OS operating system for the PowerPC architecture, and further wrote a 680x0 emulator that could run 68K-based applications, and the parts of the OS that had not been rewritten the second generation was pure, and included the low-end PowerPC 603 and high-end PowerPC 604. The 603 is notable due to its very low cost and power consumption. This was a deliberate design goal on Motorola's part, who used the 603 project to build the basic core for all future generations of PPC chips. Apple tried to use the 603 in a new laptop design but was unable due to the small 8 on. This chip began to be known inside IBM and by the media as the PowerPC 615. However, profitability concerns and rumors of performance issues in the switching between the x86 and native PowerPC instruction sets resulted in the project being cancelled in 1995 after only a limited number of chips were produced for in-house testing. Despite the rumors, the switching process took only 5 cycles, or the amount of time needed for the processor to empty its instruction pipeline. Microsoft also aided the processor's demise by refusing to support the PowerPC mode. The first 64-bit implementation was the PowerPC 620, but it appears to have seen little use because Apple didn't want to buy it and because, with its large die area, it was too costly for the embedded market. It was later and slower than promised, and IBM used their own POWER3 design instead, offering number 64-bit small version until the late 2002 introduction of the PowerPC 970. The 970 is a 64-bit processor derived from the POWER4 server processor to create it. The POWER4 core was modified to be backward compatible with 32-bit PowerPC processors, and a vector unit similar to the Altivec extensions in Motorola's 74XX series was added. IBM's RS64 processors are a family of chips implementing the Amazon variant of the PowerPC architecture. These processors are used in the RS 6000 and AS 400 computer families. The Amazon architecture includes proprietary extensions used by AS 400. The POWER4 and later Power processors implement the Amazon architecture and replaced the RS64 chips in the RS 6000 and As 400 families, IBM developed a separate product line called the 4XX line focused on the embedded market. These designs included the 401, 403, 405, 440, and 460. In 2004, IBM sold their 4XX product line to Applied Microcircuits Corporation AMCC. AMCC continues to develop new high-performance products, partly based on IBM's technology, along with technology that was developed within AMCC. These products focus on a variety of applications including networking, wireless, storage, printing, imaging and industrial automation. Numerically, the PowerPC is mostly found in controllers in cars for the automotive market. Freescale Semiconductor initially offered many variations called the MPC-5XX family, such as the MPC-555, built on a variation of the 601 core called the 8XX and designed in Israel by MSIL Motorola Silicon Israel Limited. The 601 core is single issue, meaning it can only issue one instruction in a clock cycle. To this, they add various bits of custom hardware to allow for I/O on the one chip. In 2004, the next generation 4-digit 55XX devices were launched for the automotive market. These use the newer E200 series of PowerPC cores. Networking is another area where embedded PowerPC processors are found in large numbers. MSIL took the QUICC engine from the MC68302 and made the PowerQuick MPC860. This was a very famous processor used in many Cisco Edge routers in the late 1990s. Variants of the PowerQuick include the MPC850, and the MPC823, MPC823E. All variants include a separate RISC microengine called the CPM that offloads communications processing tasks from the central processor and has functions for DMA. The follow-on chip from this family, the MPC8260, has a 603E-based core and a different CPM. Honda also uses PowerPC processors for Asimo. In 2003, Bay Systems Platform Solutions delivered the vehicle management computer for the F-35 fighter jet. This platform consists of dual PowerPCs made by Freescale in a triple redundant setup. Operating systems that work on the PowerPC architecture are generally divided into those which are oriented toward the general-purpose PowerPC systems, and those oriented toward the embedded PowerPC systems. Operating systems with native support: AmigaOS 4, Apple Classic, Mac OS starting with System 712, BIOS R5 Pro, BBox, Macintosh and clones Haiku, experimental IBM i, formerly named i5, OS, originally OS 400 Morpho. Plan 9 Inferno, from Bell Labs and maintained by Vita Nuova Holdings. POSIX, Unix, Unix-like Apple Mac OS X through Mac OS X. Leopard 1058X Berkeley Software Distribution. BSD Free BSD, 32-bit and 64-bit ports. NET BSD, port designations for PowerPC systems. OFPPC released, MACPPC released, EVBPPC released, PMPPC released, MVMEPPC released, BBox experimental, AmigaP PC very experimental, OpenBSD 32-bit, MACPPC released, port Linux Crux PPC with 32/64-bit releases supported through release 2011. Support was dropped from subsequent releases. Debian removed as a release target from Debian 9, October 31, 2016 to 32-bit PowerPC, a released port since Potato 64-bit Big Endian PPC 64 in mostly stalled development. 64-bit Little Endian PPC 64 LA, a released port since Jesse Fedora with 32/64-bit PPC releases up to version 12. PowerPC is a Fedora secondary architecture from Fedora 16 onward. Gentoo Linux, with 32-bit PPC releases and 64-bit PPC 64 releases. Mint PPC, support for Old World and New World 32/64-bit Macs based on Linux. Mint LXDE and Debian MK Linux, mock kernel-based distribution for older Macs. OpenSUSE, full support for Old World and New World PowerMax 32/64-bit, PS3 Cell, IBM Power Systems. Through the release of 111, support was dropped from sub subsequent releases, Red Hat Enterprise Linux 32-bit PPC support was dropped following release of 511, maintaining full support for 64-bit PPC 64 in subsequent releases. Slackintosh, no longer under active development since 121, SUSE Linux Enterprise Server T2 SDE, full support for 32/64-bit, Apple and IBM PowerPC systems, PS3 cell. Ubuntu, community supported for versions released after 610, Yellow Dog Linux, full support for 32/64-bit, PS3 Solaris 251 PowerPC edition on the prep platform OpenSolaris, experimental Windows NT 351 and 40 Reactos, formerly, PowerPC port no longer under active development, Cellos for PlayStation 3 embedded VXWorks Nucleus RTOS Live Devices RTA OSEC Live Microware OS 9 Montevista Linux Wind River Linux QNX Cisco iOS Linksys PKOS RTOS and virtualization platform from SYSGO. Alinos Embedded Linux ECOS RTEMS BlueCat Embedded Linux from LinuxWorks Operating System Embedded OS from ENIA AB Integrity Juniper Networks Junos Router and Switch OS Friertos DEOS SCIOPTA RTOS, certified according IEC 61508, EN50128 and ISO 26262 licensees. Companies which have licensed the 64-bit Power or 32-bit PowerPC from IBM are included 32-bit PowerPC Altera, Field Programmable Gate Array FPGA manufacturer Apple A in original AIM Alliance, switched to Intel starting early 2006, Applied Micro Circuits Corporation AMCC Avago Technologies Bay Systems for RAD 750 processor, used in spacecraft and planetary landers. Cisco Systems for routers, CultureCom for V-Dragon CPU, Exponential Technology Kumyung used in karaoke player CPU, Muzen and Vivus series LSI Logic, Motorola now Freescale Semiconductor, as part of the original AIM Alliance rapport for Kilocore 1025 core CPU, Samsung ST Microelectronics for the MPC55XX series, Xilinx, FPGA maker, embedded PowerPC in the Vertex 2 Pro, VIRTEX4, and VIRTEX5 FPGA's 64-bit PowerPC PA Semi, Microsoft Hindustan Computers Limited, Sony Freescale Semiconductor, Toshiba. Game consoles main article, PowerPC-based game consoles. PowerPC processors have been used in a number of video game consoles, Bandai for its Bandai Pippin, designed by Apple Computer 1995, Microsoft, for the Xbox 360 processor, Xenon Nintendo for the GameCube, Wii, and Wii U processors, Sony and Toshiba, for the Cell processor inside the PlayStation 3 and other devices, desktop computers. The Power architecture is currently used in the following desktop computers, SAM 440EP, SAM 440 EPFLEX, based on an AMCC 440EP SoC, built by Acube Systems, SAM 460X, based on an AMCC 460X SoC, built by Acube Systems, NeMo motherboard based around PA6T1682M found in the AmigaOne X1000 from a Eon Technology, Cyrus motherboard based around Freescale Core P5020 found in the forthcoming AmigaOne X5000 from a Eon Technology, Tabor motherboard based around Freescale Core P1022 found in the forthcoming AmigaOne A1222 from Eon Technology. Embedded applications. The Power architecture is currently used in the following embedded applications, National Instruments Smart Cameras for Machine Vision, Mars Rover Curiosity. See also Common Hardware Reference Platform CHRP, List of PowerPC processors, Power Architecture, Power Architecture Platform Reference PAPR, PowerOpen Environment, PowerPC Reference Platform, PrEP RTEMS, Real-Time Operating System VASM, A Free Assembler References, Carrot Tech File Files Columns, 1987-1990. Carrot G4 as first PowerPC with Altavic, Dumid 1999, Motorola's next chip aims at Macintosh, networking. Carrot PowerPC G4 architecture white paper. Carrot fact sheet, Motorola PowerPC processor. Carrot OS 2 for PowerPC tidbits. Carrot Microsoft killed the PowerPC 615. The Register, October 1, 1998, retrieved August 16, 2009. Carrot NETBSD, MVMEPPC, Nesdorg, February 27, 2002, retrieved August 16, 2009. Slackintosh Linux Project Slackintosh Workaroundcha retrieved 6 December 2015. Motorola Programming Environments Manual for 32-bit Implementations of the PowerPC Architecture, a 640-page PDF manual PNMPCFPE32B-AD-IBM 2000 Book E, Enhanced PowerPC Architecture 3rd ed. Duntman, Jeff, Pronk, Ron 1994 Inside the PowerPC Revolution Coriolis Group Books ISBN 6800 Family 6800-6809 See also, Hitachi 6396-8HC1168-HC0868-HC0568000 Family 6800-6800-6810-6802-6802-6803-0-6804-0-6806-0 Coldfire Dragon Ball. Embedded System 68K Variant 68EC00680EC02068EC04068LC04068EC06060 88000MC88100MC88110 Floating Point Coprocessors 68881, 68882 Memory Management Unit 68451-68851 PowerPC Family PPCE 200 PPC 6XX E300 PPC 7XX PPCE 500 PPC 74XX E600 PPCE 5500 PowerQuick Coric PPCE 6500 ARM IMX Microcontrollers 6801-6803-6802-6804-68HC0568-HC0868-HC11-68HC12-68HC16-683XXM Core MPC5XX PowerQuick DSP 568XX DSP Controller PowerPC 5000 IMX VE RISC-based processor architectures Active Altera NIOs 2 analog devices Blackfin ARC ARM Atmel AVR Atmel AVR 32 DLX ESI RISC M32R Latismico 8 Latismico 32 Meta MIPS OpenRISC Power PowerPC RISC VS Core Sunway Spark Renesas Super Unicore Xilinx Microblaze Xilinx Picablaze XMOS Xcore XS1 Historical AMD 29000 Apollo Prism Berkeley RISC Clipper CRISP DEC Alpha DEC Prism Intel i860 Intel i960 Motorola 88000 PA RISC ROMP VE Microcontrollers Main Single Board Microcontroller Special Function Register Architectures 6502-6800-8051 ARM AVR C166 FR VPIC RX Tricore Families 4-bit TLCS47 TMS1000S1C6X MU COM 4 MARC 48-bit AVR PIC 12 October 16, 17-18 COP8MCS-4851Z8E Z86-8HC08-11H8TLCS870XC87-4016-bit C166 County Route 16, CR16CH8SMSP430PIC24, DSPICR8CRL78TLCS900XC2000XE16668HC1216-32-bit M29000 ARM AVR32 Coldfire CRX FRFRV.